Okay, so let us start with the now next this current affair part, that is for 24th June. We are going to discuss some topics, and these are the topics which I have identified now. India-China roadmap, now what they are planning, how disengagement is going to be, what consensus they have drawn for disengagement, impact of H-1B visa pause on Indians. So, Indians are the most benefited community from H-1B visa, and Trump government has put some kind of pause or suspended this H-1B visa. So, what is the impact on that on Indian? Saudi Arabia is the destination for Hajj pilgrimage. So, Muslims ke two most I mean the shrines, most important shrines for them are Makkah and Medina. So Hajj pilgrimage, which starts in July, will not be cancelled, but it will be curbed. That means similar to, as I told you, Lord Jagannath Yatra, that is Rath Yatra, which I told you, chariot procession, that was not cancelled, but it was controlled by Supreme Court, like constraints were given on that. So similar to that, Hajj will also be not cancelled, but some kind of controlled manner may it will be done. Houthi tribe are there in Yemen, Saudi Arabia, very close to that. So Saudi and Yemen are fighting, and Houthi tribe is fighting for that. So we'll discuss about that news also. So in United States, some kind of issue is going on after this death of Floyd, and then racial discrimination allegations on some communities, and Trump is into that. He has given some statements which people did not like. So now people, protesters have started destroying the monuments. So protection for the protection of monument, Trump is saying that we will go for some kind of presidential order or law. World number one tennis player Novak Djokovic is tested positive, but because of his own mistakes, we can say. Senkaku Island dispute, China versus Japan. As I told you, I will make a dedicated video entirely on how China is not behaving properly with the rest of the world, Japan, US, South China Sea, and so many other countries. Yes, Patanjali has launched medicine for COVID-19, that is Coronil. Okay, now let's go. Before I start the news, let's see what is happening in the world. Coronavirus, what are the count now? So as we have already discussed, China is the sorry, US is the country, maximum number of patient, this COVID affected people, that is 23 lakh, followed by Brazil, now it is 11 lakh, followed by Russia, almost 6 lakh now, followed by India, 4.4 lakh, followed by United Kingdom, 3 lakh. So more than 3 lakh there are as of now, 5 countries, 22 lakh, followed by 11 lakh, followed by 6 lakh and 4.4 lakh, and United Kingdom. So India is at fourth number now. As far as the Indian states are concerned, so which state has maximum number? As you can see, Maharashtra has the maximum number, 1.35 lakh, followed by Delhi and Tamil Nadu. So Maharashtra, Delhi, Tamil Nadu, and then you go to Uttar Pradesh, sorry, Gujarat, then you go to Uttar Pradesh. So you should know which states. As you can see in the map, these are the 10 states with the maximum number of patient. Even Haryana, you have now 11,000 patients. Okay, now let's start with the topics discussion which we want to do. So what is happening in India and China? Now we have already discussed that there was some fight on line of actual control, Galwan Valley episode. Galwan Valley looks like China has controlled Galwan Valley, and they have occupied this particular area. So Indian Chinese forces fought on Galwan Valley and Gongso Lake. These are the two basically spot where Indian and Chinese soldiers are fighting. Now after discussion at the highest level, mutual consensus they have made, and they are disengaging now. So they have not finalized by what time they will disengage, but they have decided to disengage stage-wise, step-wise. Stage-wise disengagement it is called, sector-wise, stage-wise. Recently, General Naravane visited Leh on two-day visit, Leh Ladakh. He went to military hospital and he went and met the soldiers also. So the meeting of Indian and Chinese took place at Moldo, and they discussed about modalities, how disengagement will start. This is Galwan Valley, as you can see, line of actual control. And line of actual control, there is a Galwan Valley on line of actual control, and this is Pangong Lake, as you can see. So Ladakh is one of the Union Territory, which contains even this area controlled by China and this area controlled by Pakistan, occupied Kashmir. It is called Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory, and Ladakh is one Union Territory. And Ladakh has two districts, as you can say, Leh District and Kargil District. And I think Jammu and Kashmir has more number of districts, so we'll discuss about that later on. Okay, now so what is stage wise disengagement means? The soldiers will start moving from the common zone, and they have created some buffer zone where there will be nobody. It is no man's land, and they will vacate that buffer zone. It was during the vacation of this buffer zone that the two sides, these soldiers started fighting, and that is the trouble came. That is how it all went. So now disengagement discussions are going on, and they have decided that how they will disengage from these places, right? It is a decision taken by both India and China after June 15 incident, in which some Indian soldiers and Chinese soldiers died. Now Indian government has also given free hand to local commander who is posted there to respond to any kind of situation. So if they find that they have to take some decision, they can do that. Okay, now let's go to H1B visa pause, how it is going to impact Indian. You know, Trump administration has just extended the basically suspension of H1B visa. The most important visas are H1B visa, H2B visa, H4JL. These are the visas. I told you in the previous class also that how you should know which visa means what. So it was the move given by Trump government. They says that we are doing this because we want to protect domestic worker, because economy is shrinking in COVID-19 pandemic. So we want to protect the domestic workers, and highly skilled or low cost employees which belong to IT and other related domains, they used to take a H1B visa and enter into US, because you know, highly technical skilled employees, especially in the field of computers, IT and all, so they used to find American destinations as lucrative, and even American companies used to get cheap labor. So for Indian, H1B visa is the most important, and US government has already kept a cap of 85,000 H1B visas, and 65,000 H1B visas are issued to highly skilled foreign workers. That is what they have done. Now that out of 85,000, 20,000 were to highly skilled foreign workers who have higher education, master's degree from American university. So that is not important. Other than H1B visa, L1 visa, which allows company to transfer the people who are working in India to US for up to 7 years. H2B visa is food and agriculture workers. So you please remember, what is H1B, what is H2B? It is related to food and agriculture. What is L1? Sending the workers on site. If they are working in India, then how they will go on site? H1B visa means going to America only. So this entire visa, Indians, how they got it benefited, because with the advent of internet and low cost computers in developing nation like India and China, the graduates from these countries were ready to work for low pay in US, and hence companies in US were getting cheap labor. So now because of the ban, now processing of H1B, H2B, JL visa, everything is suspended now by America. H1B, H2B, JL visa holder and their families, I mean their spouse and kids who are already in America, they will not be affected by this. So if somebody is already in America on H1B visa or L visa, they will remain there. That is, they are not going to get affected. So the largest impact of this visa suspension is on Indian, because they used to get the most benefit out of this. Now, this changes in H-1B visa norms have been made by Trump administration, and the largest change is now, earlier they used to issue the visas as per lottery system, but now that lottery system is not there. Only highly skilled workers who are paid very high by their respective companies will be given this visa. So earlier, you know, any company in India used to send the cheap labor, the people who are new, who are getting less salary, they used to go abroad earlier from the Indian companies. Like if you have joined Infosys and you are just joined Infosys and you are getting very less salary, so that Infosys used to send to America, and you are happy because you will get obviously more in America. But now as per the new this visa norms, Infosys will be in position to send only highly skilled laborer who are getting good salary in Infosys to America. So these are some changes which visa I think norms US has changed. Now let's go to next news. Hajj pilgrimage is very famous for in Saudi Arabia. There are two places, Makkah and Medina, where Muslim from entire world they go for Hajj pilgrimage. So it's basically most religious place for Muslim all over the world. So like other day I was discussing with you the this Puri, Lord Jagannath temple in Puri. So that chariot procession, that Rath Yatra, was not suspended. It was allowed, permitted by Supreme Court with some kind of constraints. Similarly, Saudi Arabia is saying that Hajj pilgrimage will not be cancelled, but it will be curbed. That means some controls will be done. So see the map and try to remember the map. Saudi Arabia, one side is Red Sea, another side is Persian Gulf, then it's Arabian Sea. Then you see this side is Israel, Jordan, and then Iraq. So neighboring countries, African continent, may Egypt, Sudan, Yemen, and Saudi Arabia keep on fighting. So what is the capital of Saudi Arabia? That is Riyadh. What is the capital of Yemen? That is Sana'a. These are in news. That's the reason I'm going to discuss with you. And where is Dubai? You can see where is Dubai, where is Doha, where is Abu Dhabi, where is Muscat. So you should know all these places and make a mental map. Iran, Iraq, Jordan, Israel, Egypt, Sudan, Yemen, Oman, Dubai. So you should know these places where these are. Okay, now Saudi Arabia has said that Hajj will not be cancelled and very limited people, Muslim pilgrimage, will be permitted to visit Hajj this year. This is the scene of Hajj. You can see people are going there, and this is the main spot where people basically gather in Hajj. So from entire world people visit this place, Makkah and Medina. Okay, so at least 2 million Muslims, 20 lakh Muslim, visit this place. This is a worship place in Makkah, and in 90 years Saudi Arabia has never cancelled Hajj. That is a news. So where's Makkah, where's the Medina, where's the capital Riyadh, you should know in Saudi Arabia. Okay, now next news also related to Saudi Arabia. A neighboring country of Saudi Arabia is Yemen. In Yemen there's a rebel group that is called Houthi rebel group, and they are fighting with Saudi Arabia. They have captured Yemen capital Sana'a. This is one of the groups which is fighting with the government in Yemen. So they are launching the missiles on Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia, along group of other countries, has made a basically another defense against Houthis. So what you need to remember is this is Saudi Arabia, this is Yemen, and you can see three colors. This one Yemen, which is controlled by Saudi forces and coalition group of Saudis. This part where Sana'a capital is also situated, this is controlled by Houthi group, and this one is Al-Qaeda controlled area. So Yemen is not very basically stable as far as the country is concerned. The fight is going on. So Saudi UAE led military coalition is what is controlling Yemen as of now. So Houthi group is fighting against Arab Saudi Arabia, sorry, they are fighting against Saudi Arabia and keep on firing the missiles, ballistic missiles or drone attack on Saudi Arabia. You should know where the Yemen is, where the Houthi tribe is. That is what you should know. Okay, now like next news is related to in which country the monuments means murtiyan, this means statues are being destroyed by protesters. As you know, recent past mein in America, one of the black fellow George Floyd got killed, and after that there was huge procession, huge agitations in America, especially against Donald Trump also, the president. So now the people they believe that this racism is still not finished, and there's a racial discrimination against a black in America, and hence people started destroying these monuments of leaders of Confederacy. Leaders of Confederacy means the leaders who built USA. So like this statue, you can see people are throwing this down, and they feel that this is wrong. These are people who have done nothing for them. Something like that. So, in which country statues are being toppled? That is America. Recently, what happened that one of the statue of President Andrew Jackson is a favorite president of Donald Trump. So, President Andrew Jackson's statue was destroyed in basically Lafayette Park across the street from White House. So, as per Donald Trump, this is not good. And people who have done this, they are going to face some kind of imprisonment or some fine also. So this is what monumental destruction is going on, and the president believes that some law is required, and presidential order will be issued for such law. Okay, now let's discuss next news about Novak Djokovic. He's a world number one tennis player. You know, he was of the opinion that there should not be any ban or any kind of vaccination against coronavirus, and tennis should be allowed. People should be allowed to play tennis. So he organized one of the game, one of the match also, and unfortunately, he and his wife got corona positive. Thankfully, their kids are not. So he believed that the virus has weakened, and he can go for the now this particular match, but he virus was still present as per him, and because of that he could get the virus positive, corona positive. So the message is that you should not take things lightly, and this Djokovic organized some kind of event, 2 days event across 4 different countries. So this was not good. He's a 17 times Grand Slam champion. This is what is done. Okay, now what is Senkaku Island dispute? This is the dispute between India and China. So there's a territorial dispute over a group of uninhabited islands known as Senkaku Island in Japan and Diaoyu Island in People Republic of China and Tiayu Tai Island in Republic of China, which is Taiwan actually. So remember three islands, Senkaku Island. Now, these three names you should know: Senkaku Island, Japan, Diaoyu, People Republic of China, and Tiayu Tai, that is Taiwan. So these names you please remember. And there's a dispute of China and Japan over Senkaku Island. So as I told you, China is having dispute with many countries in the world, including India and U.S. or America, and East Asian nations also, South Asia, South China Sea. Because of that, there are some issues. So we will discuss those issues also. But as of now, Senkaku Island issue is between China and Japan. That is what you should know, and the names you should remember. Japan has signed a treaty of mutual cooperation and security with the United States, as per which defense of this Senkaku Island will be the responsibility of US. So if there is any kind of fight between Japan and China, US is going to fight from the Japanese side. That's the meaning of it. So this is the most serious in China Japan relation after post-war period, and risk of military conflict has come to this particular level. This is something which is not good between China and Japan. Okay, so these were some reasons why this all came up. Like Japan purchased this Senkaku Island from some private player, and China said that you cannot do that. So this is how all this situation came up. So I will keep on discussing these issues, island issues with you in future. But as of now, just remember these three names which I told you, and gradually we will proceed forward. Okay, last news for the day is Patanjali has launched a medicine as per Patanjali Coronil or Swasari. That will be the medicine for COVID-19. Patanjali Yogpeeth, which is based in Haridwar, has claimed that this is the medicine and it will basically heal COVID-19 patient, cure the COVID-19 patient. So this is what Patanjali claims, that this is the medicine. Every day some medicines are coming. Ministry of Ayush said that they are not aware about this and they want to have scientific study before anything is declared by Patanjali. So this is what were the news. So as I told you, the best way to memorize current affairs is that every day you should learn some topics, you should learn some particular issues, and you should understand those issues, and every day keep on gradually doing some more topics and keep on understanding more about that. So one news can be repeatedly understood and more depth may those news can be done. So I hope you have understood this, and then the questions based upon this, all the news I will be discussing separately after 1 week. So once the 1 week current affair we have discussed, I will be discussing the questions also with you. Fine, thank you.